Hey guys, welcome back to Critical Flick. Today I'm going to be talking about episode 4 of Prodigal Son on Fox. So again, thank you guys so much for watching this series so far. I really enjoy the back and forth, and you guys have been really watching the videos and everything like that, so I just want to say appreciate it again. And like with every episode so far this series, this show has been a bit of a mixed bag for me. It does things that I really, really enjoy. It does things that I really don't enjoy, so it's kind of hard to get a real grasp on it as of right now. And on this episode, Malcolm is chasing down what he believes to be a stalker killer. I like the fact that each episode deals with a different type of killer, a different type of criminal, so you get to see his profiling skills. You get to see a little bit of more of his education and how he works as a detective. Also, like the use of flashbacks in the show, I normally am not a huge fan of flashbacks. I think they're a little bit obnoxious and just kind of a really lazy plot device. But in this one, it works really well, showing him going into his manic states, how they trigger him, how the different parts of his life kind of have gaps in them because of the way that he remembers things or how other people around him remembers things. And it gives you a little bit more insight into Malcolm's character. And I think that Thomas Payne portrays a character that is really having an internal struggle and having these paranoid delusions of what his life really is. And I think that that is portrayed really well in his acting. There's one slight problem, and I think it has a little bit more to do with the script writing of the show than the actual performance, because I think Thomas Payne has actually been probably one of the shining moments of the show. Him and Michael Sheen both have been, in my opinion, really good. But sometimes the script is so heavy-handed, he has to really be pushing it sometimes, and I think it gets a little extreme. Like I said about the first episode, this show has some really wild shifts in tone and just demeanor. There's some moments in this episode in particular where Malcolm is kind of reasonable, and he's talking to people, and he kind of is quirky, charming, likable. And then he just totally loses it. And when he loses it, it feels kind of strange. It feels like the actor is forcing this kind of intense dialogue back and forth. And I know that might have something to do with the fact that his character is dealing with, you know, some mental illness. But I don't know. I feel like it could be dealt with in a little more nuanced way, or a little more showing what's making him, you know, explode like this. Because it kind of just jumps scene from scene. One moment he's joking around with his police friends. Next moment he's totally freaking out about something. So I don't know. I think both performances are good, but it could deal with a little bit more nuance at times. Speaking of him freaking out, his family and their dynamic is probably the most compelling aspect of the show for me right now. I really want to see where it's going to go dealing with his sister. This is something in this episode that we see, especially towards the very end, that she doesn't fully understand what her father is, I don't think. She doesn't really understand the horrible events that have occurred in the past when she was too young to remember them. And I want to know how that's going to play out. I think that Michael Sheen, giving his performance as the surgeon in this episode, you see just how coercive and you just see how manipulative he is. And her being very impressionable and kind of chasing a story, kind of chasing down the things that will progress her in her career, he's going to take advantage of that. And I want to see how that's going to play out, because we haven't really seen him being able to take advantage of people right now. Malcolm, obviously a lot of pushback, a little bit of give there. The wife, a tremendous amount of pushback. So we're finally going to see somebody that maybe can be manipulated by him in a more significant way. Also, would like to see more of how the surgeon was before he was arrested. We see some glimpses of that. We have the mother having a flashback to a conversation she has with him where, you know, he says that it's not really up to him. There's something going on deeper and darker within him that controls these events. I want to see that. I want to see into his mind and see the way he was acting, because as of right now, we just see a caged animal. We see someone who is horrible, but he's, you know, trying to convince people, very Hannibal Lecter-esque. I feel like that's kind of very surface level for this character. So I want to see maybe his past or what drives him or his motivations to be such an awful person. We also see a little bit more of Malcolm's total disconnect for compassion, or basically humanity, in this episode when he goes up to Roger, who is a, you know, a stalker fan of one of the characters, and tells him that he's dying. He's not actually dying, but he makes him believe that he's going to die. Kind of a really horrible thing to do to somebody, even if you know you're trying to get information from him. So it kind of shows that he doesn't really care about how other people feel. He doesn't really care about how he makes other people feel. He's always after solving the case. That's what's most important to him. And he takes things to an extreme. And like I said in the previous episodes, I want to know how far he's willing to push this and where it's maybe going to lead him. Maybe he's going to end up in prison with his father. That could be something that could happen. I don't know. I think that there's a lot of avenues the show could take, and I hope it takes some risk and branches out, and it's not just a procedural show where every episode we have a new criminal, we have a new case, we have a little bit of main storyline going along, because that's how it's been so far. But I would like to see it give some twists, give some big overarching ideas happen. I also saw that this show actually just got picked up for a full season this month, So we're going to get a full 22 episodes. I don't think I'm going to be able to review every single episode of the show. It's just too much, to be honest with you, just trying to review and watch all these shows. But I'm definitely going to be keeping up with it. I definitely want to keep having a conversation about the show, so you can always head over to our Twitter and talk to us there. Or, you know, I'm probably going to do an end-of-season review. All these shows I've been watching, I've actually been enjoying for the most part, so I haven't given up on any of them. So I definitely want to do an end-of-season wrap-up, my thoughts on the first season of the show. So all in all, I thought this was a fairly enjoyable episode. Like I said, it just has these moments that I really, really love. Like, there's a individual scene that I thought was really powerful and really well done by the show writers, and especially by Thomas Payne performing, and it's when Malcolm is watching a video of his mother right after his father was arrested. And she's explaining, you know, she should have done something, she should have known better and saved some lives, and his just emotion of watching this, him crying and just reaching out to the screen, it was something that felt ripped out of like a real movie or a really high budget show, something really, really, you know, Emmy worthy. And then you just have these kind of insane moments with it. And I don't know, I'm hoping that they strike a balance. I know that they try to make it a little more mainstream, a little less artsy, but I would like to see these gritty, grounded moments of someone just dealing with this internal struggle. So yeah, there's some flashes of brilliance in the show, so I'm hoping maybe we can channel those moving forward. Obviously, getting picked up for a full season means that the studios and the networks have a lot of faith in it, so I'm hoping to see the script as it moves forward really flesh out this character in the story and what's boiling beneath the surface. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe and let me know how you are feeling about Prodigal Son so far. Are you still on board? Are you going to watch the whole season, followed all the way through? And what is your favorite character? I feel like Malcolm obviously gets the spotlight, and then Michael Sheen as a surgeon gets a lot of spotlight. There's some interesting little side characters that are popping up here and there, and I kind of like their story. So put those comments down below, and see you guys next time.